I've actually been passionate about drawing from a very young age. Ever since I was a small child, I was always drawing paper after paper after paper. And pretty early on, I was very interested in animated movies, mostly Disney, also Ghibli, the classics. And I really wanted to participate in that because my father sort of explained the rudimentary process of how an animation film is made, and I was really, really inspired. So from early on, I think maybe 10, 12 years, I knew I wanted to study that. So I studied fine arts in Pico Hasselt, which gave me a really, really great base. And then I went to St. Lucas Brussels for animation. And from there on, it grew. The piece was a bit of a particular film because it directly started from a style, and a style I developed by accident when I was doing an assignment for a different class, where I sort of created a new story, taking stills and taking scenes from other movies, which I then printed on transparents and I drew over them. And that was sort of a style I really enjoyed. So I won the wild card with the beast. And so I had a bit of an opportunity to make a movie, to make my own new short film, because I knew I wanted to explore the style of the beast further. I sort of started thinking about a story that could fit it. And at the same time, I was just talking with friends, sort of realizing that some connections stay very superficial and that it was becoming increasingly difficult to make friends on a very real way and a very real emotional connection. And then that was a sort of feeling I wanted to explore. And then the story of Monachopsis started developing around that. And then I started also developing the style further and making it more readable because the beast was still a bit messy. And I wanted to make it more visually attractive as well. So it starts with the drawing. And then I start looking for locations that could fit the drawings. And I go out and about and I shoot a lot of things. And then I sort of start putting that together. So I start framing the footage with the storyboard, and then I draw the characters on it, very rough. And then I sort of start compositing in After Effects, color collection, shadows, all that. And then I print it out. And that's where the fun begins, because then I can paint over it and then I can alter with ink and with water and with acrylic, then I can really draw in the shadows. And that's then I take pictures of it again, frame by frame, and composite it all together. So it's a lot of steps, but in the end you get a very tactile, very homogeneous look. When I graduated, I did an internship via FAF, Stage de Werkvloer op, and I came here. I did some character design for Fabriek Fantastique, and I think 5-6 people back then, and it was a very fun experience. And at one point, I also pitched my idea for my short film for my wildcard to Tom, and he was very enthusiastic. So we sort of, I didn't have to look any further. I was very happy here, and it was a very fun experience to work on a film, and I felt very understood as well. I think, especially back then, I didn't have a very clear idea of the film, or I just couldn't put it into words. And I had a good feeling that they understood what I wanted to bring, and they were very helpful in sort of developing it and actually writing it down and giving it more structure. And then, yeah, the projects here are very fun and I'm having a good time. So.
Les cinéastes ont besoin qu'on s'intéresse à eux, vous le savez.